guys, Cynthia here. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hit that subscribe button and you can be notified anytime I put up a new video. And if you're not new to my channel, thank you guys so much for coming back. This is going to be my February favorites. I know that it's late, but I have just been extremely busy. I'm wearing a few of my February favorites. That's why it doesn't really go together. It's just like, I just want to show you guys. So my first favorite is this scarf. I've had it for quite some time. My mom bought it for me a long, long time ago. Actually, she didn't buy it for me. This is hers. I stole it. Yes, that's true. That's true. I took it from her. She doesn't use it. She's got a lot of fancy things. Like my mom, she always buys these really nice fancy things because my dad will buy it for her or she'll buy it for herself, and then she just won't use them. And then that's when I sneak in and I'm like, hey mom, you know that beautiful Chanel silk scarf that you never use? I'm gonna put it on my head, you know? But yeah, so this is one of my favorites. Another one of my favorites is this jacket that I got. I got this from TJ Maxx, actually, I think. But I like it because it's like, what? It's like, I'm wearing black. Just kidding. I'm wearing silver. No, I'm wearing black. Bam, silver. I don't know, but I really like it. I do not know what the brand is. Give me 1 second. All right, so I just looked and the brand is called Mink Pink. And I got this. It was I think I paid $40, but it had a few stickers on it that said old, old, old. So I think it would have been more money had I gotten it full price or right when it came at, I don't know, or in regular store. But yeah, I really I couldn't live without it. And I can just see myself hi guys, I'm walking in New York City with a pair of killer pants and some boots, you know, or some heels. Or I don't know. I just needed it. So these two are just on my body. So I just want to talk about how they're my favorites. My other favorite is still Mark. He's still phenomenal and he's just getting better and better. If you can imagine, after a few months, you would think it would kind of die down, but it's nah, it's just getting stronger and stronger. And it's really such an awesome thing. And hopefully, I'll introduce you guys. Well, if you follow me on my Snap, then you would have kind of met him because he's on there when we get to spend time together. But hopefully one day I'll have him here on my channel. But we don't know yet, you know, because that's that's something. You gotta really prepare someone to be hey, do you want to go on the internet? You know, whatever. But I'm just going to move right along to my beauty favorites this month. This will always be in every single one of my favorites. This is the Airbrush Flawless Finish Seeing Setting Powder by Charlotte Tilbury. I have been loving Charlotte for quite some time. This is my second one of these guys, and it's already hit pan. I'm noticing a lot of bigger YouTubers always talking about Charlotte Tilbury, and I think that they're sponsored, good for them. But I just want you guys to know, if you go way back on my channel, I have just been rocking Charlotte Tilbury for quite some time. Actually, my best friend Elise, you guys know her, you know, in my last video. She is just she has everything Charlotte Tilbury. She loves Charlotte. And so I think she kind of segue me into her. But this was over a year ago. And this is all, I don't know. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is I'm not on the giant YouTuber bandwagon. I've always loved Charlotte Tilbury. I could have just said that, you know. My next favorite thing is this NYX matte liquid liner. I love it. I stopped using it for a while, but then I went back to it and I love it, love it, love it. And I bought two, and there's the non-open ones are back there just because I don't want to run out of this anymore. I can't run out of it. It's it's a staple. It's just so easy to glide on. I love that it's matte and it's everything on earth, you know? The next thing that I've been using and loving, this is a soft matte complex concealer, and this is in the color Caramel, and I love it so much. As you can see, I've used a lot of it, and I'm just kind of depressed that I've used this much. I'm just depressed because it's not cheap. It's $30, I think, or $32, and it's why is everything so... I went to Sephora the other day, I bought two things, $94 or something. I was what? You know, just drives me crazy. I wish makeup wasn't this expensive, and I understand, I don't understand. I was going to say, I understand they have to mark it up to make a profit. No, I don't understand. I don't. The next thing I'm going to bring up is, this is the Charlotte Tilbury Legendary Brow. This is actually one of the new albums that she's a rap artist now or something. Yeah, this is one of the new items that she came out with, and it's doing everything for my brows, everything. It doesn't hold it solidly in place like the Anastasia brow gel does. This stuff, you can be in a hurricane and your eyebrows will not move, girl. They will be bam bam bam, and you'll be sleek brows, you know. You'll be coming out of Tsunami with sleep brows, you know what I'm saying? But what I love about this is that it has color, and this is the darkest color, and this is in the color, oh my God, I have bad eyesight. Kyra, I think, or Kepra, I don't know. But what I like is that I can make these little, like, fleekies. You see how, like, I have, like these little brows that come up because I can darken them up a little bit. And I like making the very fronts kind of messy. And this is doing that for me, and I really, really love it. And I think it's in the 30s as well, which is very depressing. My two next favorites is by Milk Cosmetics. This is from their Primrose collection. I did film, like, all the swatches. I will link that video down below if you guys want to see it. But the color I have on is Old Fashioned. I just really love this, like, it's almost like army green-ish, like, undertone. But I really am loving this color. It's the one I have on. And then my next favorite color is this color Mum. And it looks like really... it's almost picking up like almost like an orangey, and it is, it's very, on my lips, because I'm like, you know, dark skin or whatever, it's very rust, like a rust finish, which I really love that, like, rusty rust look. I think it's like, I don't know, I just love it so much. My next favorite thing, if you follow me on any of my social media, especially on my Snap, you will know that I've been snapping about this Guerlain Le Petite Robe Noir Mascara. This mascara is not clumpy. It leaves it really long, and it's got this beautiful ball at the end, so you can do your lower lashes, like, really easy and quick, which I really like. And it makes, it just is a gorgeous mascara, and I love the packaging. I was kind of conned into buying this. Their Guerlain representative was there, and she's like, have you tried any mascara? I was like, no, I haven't. And she had, like, these little, like, tiny little samples. She's like, do you want a sample? I was like, I would love a sample. But then she, like, opened it and then put it on my mat, on my eyes, and I was like, oh, and it was like a day I didn't wear makeup, so I couldn't be like, stop, because it was clean, because it was like a sample. But I was like, oh, you know, so I let her do it. And then, of course, like, anyone who knows Cynthia knows that I'm have an addiction. I have a serious addiction. Therefore, I was like, I love it, it's amazing. And I actually do love it, and it is amazing. So this is everything. My next favorite thing, I feel like, does not get any play here on the YouTube. This is the Duo Eyelash Adhesive in the color, in the dark tone. This Duo, I love it. I just really like this, like, lash glue. It doesn't smell bad. It just, like, it just makes it easy to apply. It makes it easy to, like, rip off. And my head thing is falling off. It's because I stole it. I'm just like, I want to go back to your mom. You stole me. But anyway, yeah, I just feel like nobody really talks about this, so I just wanted to give it a shout out. My next favorite thing is, I've talked about this in one of my other favorites before, but this is the Japanese eyelash kind of putter on her. You just, like, kind of, you're able to, like, squeeze your lashes to your false lashes, and they are just, I mean, it's just, it makes it so much easier to put on your lashes and squeeze them together without getting glue on your nails or your fingers or whatever that is. I just think this is, like, phenomenal. I got one of these for my giveaway too, because I just think it's great. One of my new favorites for February is anything Juvia's Place. I think their palettes are so stunning. I just pulled out the very new one, but I have them all, and I just think that anything by Juvia's Place is really nice. The quality is gorgeous. The pigmentation is nice. And I just, like, I really like that it's a black owned company, and, yeah, I'm living for their packaging too. I love how they have these beautiful African women in the front. Primo, primo, primo. And then the next thing that's not beauty related, these are also one of my favorites this month. I've been wearing them a lot this February. They have, like, a boot guard in them, but these boots are thigh-high boots, so that's why they're, like, huge and long. But they are by Vincent Camucho, and I paid a pretty penny for these. They're leather in the front, and they just have the cloth in the back, but I absolutely love them. They got this chunky heel, so it's super, super comfortable, and they're just really sexy because they go up your thigh, and you can, like, wear with, like, a mini dress. Like, I don't know. They're really flipping hot, so I'm loving that, and I'm, like, sad that the weather's changing, because, like, eventually I won't be able to wear these, like, sexy boots anymore. My next favorite thing that's also not related to, you know, anything... is Valentine's Day candy. If you guys follow me on social media, you know that I let y'all know the day after Valentine's Day that everything was having a 50% off. So needless to say, I have 100 bags of these peanut M&Ms that are pink and red and white, and I love peanut M&Ms, so I was like, yes, what? So I bought a bunch of them. I bought Mark some candy and his son some candy, and then I love Snickers, and especially these tiny bite-sized Snickers, because, like I said, they're bite-sized, and you get the perfect bite. You get, like, peanut and caramel and in every single, in like every single bite, in your one little bite. Cause I find like sometimes you, you know, bite a bigger Snickers and you're like, where's my peanut at? I gotta have a peanut. Where you at? You know, but with these, like, they're just like yummy. They're just yummy. They're yummy, yummy, yummy everywhere or all the time. And then of course, like these guys, I just love candy and I love Valentine's Day candy, especially because then it goes on sale. So now into my music favorites. If you follow me on my Snap, you know that the 679 by Fetty Wap is my absolute favorite song lately. It's not a new song, but I'm just like obsessed with it. I every time I listen to it, I sing it to Mark because it's so silly. But so this next part is what I always sing to Mark. Wonder when she'll be mine. She walks past that press rewind to see that ass one more time. Anyway, that's why I really like this song, because it just reminds me of Mark, because my next favorite song is called Say It. It's by Flumeskin or Truvlo. Truvlo? Yeah, Flumeskin featuring Truvlo. It's called Say It. It's so good. Yeah, that song is really, really, really good. This song I really love. It is by Ingrid Michelson, I don't know. And it's called Girls and Boys. It's The Way I Am. I really love this song. It's just like how I'm feeling now, so it's nice. Winehouse. I miss her. She was a talent. And I look across the water. And I think of all the things and what we're doing. And in my head I paint a picture. Since I come home, well, my body's been a mess. And I miss your tender hair and the way you like to dress. Won't you come on over? Stop making a fool out of me. She is something amazing. She is missed. OMG, OMG, OMG. Yes, I've been... this is so good. Again, I'm like in this like lovey-dovey mood. So I've been listening to a lot of love songs because I'm like, I feel that. You're telling, you're speaking my story, you know? She's got the wind. My trees, feel the breath in my face, her body close to me, can look in her eyes. Yes, Patrick Swayze. She's out of my league. Just a fool to believe I am anything she needs. She's out the way. And because I started listening to that soundtrack of Dirty Dancing, this one, yes, I've been listening to this song a lot. This one's called Yes. Ha ha ha! last but not least, I have been really into, where are you, song? Where is it? Yes. This Radiohead song by Creep. Ooh, I don't know, man. I don't know. It's so good lately. Just been like loving it, loving it, loving it. And it's old school. Most of my songs are pretty old this time around. Sorry about it. Love that song. I love it. I love it. I love it. But anyway, guys, that is it for our monthly favorites. Thank you so much for sticking around. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It really, really helps me out. And if you're not subscribed, please hit that subscribe button so that we can like continue to hang out and all that. And anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Again, all of my social media will be linked down below, and it would be wonderful if I could see you guys there. And I love you guys. Bye.